Parson Walker's wife laid very sick once for a while, and it seemed as if they weren't going to save her. But one morning, he came in, and Smiley up and asked him how she was, and he said she was considerable better, thank the Lord for his infinite mercy, and coming on so smart that with the blessing of Providence, she'd get well yet. And Smiley, before he thought, says, "Well, I'll risk 2½ she don't anyway." This year Smiley had a mare. The boys called her the 15-minute nag, but that was only in fun, you know, because, of course, she was faster than that. And he used to win money on that horse, for all she was so slow and always had asthma or the distemper or the consumption or something of that kind. They used to give her 200 or 300 yards start and then pass her underway. But always, at the fag end of the race, she'd get excited and desperate-like and come cavorting and straddling up and scattering her legs around limber, sometimes in the air and sometimes out to one side amongst the fences and kicking up more dust and raising more racket with her coughing and sneezing and blowing her nose. And always fetch up at the stand just about a neck ahead, as near as you could cipher it down. And he had a little small bull pup that, to look at him, you'd think he weren't worth a cent, but to set around and look ornery and lay for a chance to steal something. But as soon as money was up on him, he was a different dog. His underjaw began to stick out like the forecastle of a steamboat, and his teeth would uncover and shine like the furnaces. And a dog might tackle him and bullyrag him and bite him and throw him over his shoulder 2 or 3 times. And Andrew Jackson, which was the name of the pup, Andrew Jackson would never let on but what he was satisfied and hadn't expected nothing else. And the bets being doubled and doubled on the other side all the time till the money was all up. And then, all of a sudden, he would grab that other dog just by the gent of his hind leg and freeze to it. Not chaw, you understand, but only just grip and hang on till they throwed up the sponge, if it was a year. Smiley always came out winner on that pup, till he harnessed a dog once that didn't have no hind legs, because they had been sawed off in a circular saw. And when the thing had gone along far enough, and the money was all up, and he come to make a snatch for his pet Holt, he see in a minute how he'd been imposed on, and how the other dog had him in the door, so to speak, as he peered surprised. And then he looked sort of discouraged-like, and didn't try no more to win the fight. And so he got shucked out bad. He gave Smiley a look, as much as to say his heart was broke, and it was his fault for putting up a dog that hadn't no hind legs for him to take hold of, which was his main dependence in a fight. And then he limped off a piece and laid down and died. It was a good pup, was that Andrew Jackson, and would have made a name for himself if he'd lived. For the stuff was in him, and he had genius. I know it, because he hadn't no opportunities to speak of, and it don't stand a reason that a dog could make such a fight as he could under them circumstances if he hadn't no talent.